Hello, fellow traders, tis I, the Rumpled One, coming to you on Tuesday, November the 1st, the year's 2022. Let's talk trading. How much is enough with Walmal? These videos are for educational purposes only. Your results may differ from mine and different from Walmal's. Let's see, first, since we are at a new month, let me pull up the monthly chart. And we are 84 pips above the monthly open, 16, 17 off the high, 87 off the low so far. So it looks like the month starting out green. We had a green month last month, which is only 3 months green this year. And just for the week, we are now 42 pips below the weekly open, 64 off the high and 89 off the low. And we still have two pairs that haven't filled the weekly open gap. And we are 1,976 pips below the yearly open, 1,192 off the low and 2,198 off the high. Okay, so we were talking about how much is enough. We were talking about that offline, so I thought maybe we should share it with the boys, girls, and non-binary traders out there. So Walmal, let's see. What did, I think we came to pretty much the same conclusion.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, you know, there are a couple of things that really go into this idea of how much is enough. You know, you see these trends, you know, and you look at the chart and it ran up. You know, well, you look at it from the beginning of the year, we're 1,900 points, you know, not points, but pips below the open of the year. Oh, wouldn't it have been nice to go put a 10 lot trade at the beginning of the year? You know, that would have been a fantastic trade, but the reality is the market, you know, it breathes. It goes up, it goes down, it goes up, it goes down. And the problem with that is, first of all, you don't know at the beginning of the year that's going to go down 1,900 pips. That's the first thing. You know, I don't know anybody that can go pick perfect tops and perfect bottoms, you know. And so for that reason, what I like to do is I like to go and just go get out, you know, take out of the market what I'm able to take out of the market at this moment in time. And I think that's important, you know, in trading in general, but I think it's even more important in Forex. And the reason why is because when we trade Forex, we're so heavily leveraged. You know, it's not like the stock market. When you buy a dollar's worth of stock, you know, you buy a dollar's worth of stock. That, you know, in Forex, you're buying 50 to 1 or 100 to 1 or 4 or 500 to 1.
Or 1,000 to 1.
or even 1,000 to 1. And so those moves can be, you know, they can wipe an account out faster than you can blink an eye. And so you have to be very, very careful about that. So for that reason, I don't like to go and try to trade, you know, Forex, you know, like a swing trade in trading. Now, I know that you can do it, and I know you can make money on it. There are a lot of people out there who do make money on it. I'm not one of them, you know. So I like to take out, you know, what I need, you know. And so I think I used the expression with you yesterday, TRO, was I like to go and chunk it. And what I mean by that is I take a chunk of the market out. I take a little bit of it out here, take a little bit of it out of there. As I see different trades go and develop, I'll take a little bit here, a little bit there, and you know. And at the end of the day, I've got what I need to go and, you know, sustain, you know, growing my account and sustained, you know, profitability. And that's just how I look at it. I mean, how often, you look at a daily chart, how often does it go, you know, in one particular direction and then somewhere along the day turn around and flip and go all the way back and all the way back into the other direction? And, you know, and if you were just to go in there and try to go and get the whole move, I've seen so many traders, and by the way, one of those traders is me, myself, and I, because I, you know, actually three of those traders are me, myself, and I, you know, and because I used to do that, and I'd try to go pick the top, I'd try to pick the bottom, And next thing you know, I was up, you know, 20 or 30 pips because I got in at the right place and I wanted to get a whole move. You know, and what do I mean by that? Well, I know that typically the pound goes and likes to move somewhere. At that time, it was moving like 125, 130 pips, you know, per day. And I'm saying, hey, I've got 25, 30 of it. I want to get the other 100. Next thing you know, yeah, we got the other 100, but we got the other 100 in the other direction. And now I've taken a nice little win and turned it into an even better loss.
Well, you know, I think part of this scenario or situation is position size. Because what happens is, depending on your position size, it's depending on how much you're going to make every point or every pip. And so what happens is, if you're trading a small account and you want to make, let's say you have a $100 account and you're trading a dime a pip and you want to make $10, well, that's 10% return. A dime a pip, you need to make 100 pips. And I think that's what a lot of these traders, we see them on the forums, you know, they're basically trading, you know, a micro lot.
Right.
And that's what they're going for, because, you know, if they make 20 cents on a trade, you know, they that's nothing. I mean, you can't even buy a cup of coffee for 20 cents. But, you know, there are traders out there. In fact, there's one on Forex Factory. You know, he's looking for one trade a day, and he wants to make about 5 pips, and he's trading, you know, at a size where he's making about $700, you know, on that one trade.
Right. So he's trading 10 lots or better, you know, to go and do that. So, and, you know, and that's the thing. You can do it, but it comes down to scalability. Here's the question, though. You can't trade 10 lots if you got a $100 account.
Right.
You know, and so that's, and that, you know, I started off, my first account was, it was probably, you know, $500 or $1,000, I don't even recall. But, you know, it started off really small, you know. And so you can do it. And you know what? You know, you said you only make 20 cents. But here's the thing, you know, Kiro, is that, you know, we shouldn't poo-poo that 20 cents. And the reason why we shouldn't poo-poo that 20 cents is because, hey, if I go and make 20 cents, let's say I only make 20 cents a day for an entire week. Well, now I got another dollar.
Right.
Okay.
That's 1%. That's a 1% return on a $100 account.
Exactly. Which means that next week I can trade at slightly higher. I can trade at 1% higher, you know, if I don't take any money out. And that's what you have to do. Is, you know, you have to go look at trading as a business. You know, and I think that's the thing that where, you know, people get lost in the weeds. You know, most business owners, when you start a business, the owners themselves, not the workers, but the owners themselves usually don't pull a salary in for 2 to 3 years. You know, most successful businesses anyway, they don't pull a penny in to their own pocket for the first 2 or 3 years. They live off of their savings. They live off of, you know, the gratitude of family members, or if they're married, their spouse's salary. You know, that's just what they have to do. And because they need to go and take that money, and every cent that they make has to get turned back in to their business so that they have further capital so that they can expand to the point at which, when at some point in time, they can actually have enough business, you know, being generated. You know, because running a business costs money. You know, if you're selling gadgets, you got to advertise that you're selling gadgets. You got to get the word out there. You got to go and potentially hire, you know, employees. You know, you got all those things. All those things have to be paid. You don't have to be paid, but all those other things do have to be paid. And, well, trading's the same way. You know, the reality is that the difference is you may not be paying an employee, but the thing is you got something out there that you do need to go and build up, and that's your capital. And so I guess the biggest piece of advice here is that, you know, just keep plugging away. Find ways to supplement so that you're living, you know, so that you're able to go and live and do what you need to do in terms of living. And, you know, and at the same time, every penny that you make, put it into the account. Don't go and spend it. Now, here's the one piece I will say is that, at least is what I did. At the end of the month, if I made $1,000, let's say, at the end of the month, I took 10% of it and I spent it on me. because I have to have some type of, you know, thing in my own head to go and say, hey, this is worthwhile. I got 10%. I got, you know, if I made $1,000, I got $100, and I was able to spend $100 on something that I would enjoy going and using and doing, and not necessarily even paying a bill, but just something along those lines. That way there's, hey, there is some fruit at the end of this, and you just keep on, you have to plug and plug and plug. And so how much is enough? Well, enough is that you keep on going and you keep on going until you're able to sustain it, and it becomes, I almost want to say, self-fulfilling, you know. And one of the things that has happened for me anyway, and just, you know, talking about my success story, is that by going and building account, I'm actually trading at a level right now that's a little bit lower than I was trading in the past in terms of lot size. And because I don't need to go put my account at risk. And at the same time, I'm making more money because my account has grown. And that's where we all need to get to, because it makes life a whole lot less stressful and a whole lot easier. I mean, I can go and take a day where I take a loss. You know, I mean, Tiro, you were witness to it last week. I took a day that was a pretty good loss. But at the end of the week, it didn't really matter because I was up for the week. You know, and that's what matters.
Right, right. Yeah, because one of the other things is you know, we're talking about how much is enough. And if you try and take the big bite, you can get burned, just like if you trade big lots. Like, I'll just disclose, yesterday I took an $800 hit. I was trading $100 a pip. I had market moved so fast against me, 8 pips. So boom. So what did I do? I reduced the size to $10 a pip, and I just fought all the way back, all the way back, and then some, because it. It, I was mad, for one thing. It's like, I want my money back. So,
well, I'm not gonna encourage traders to do that.
Right. But the point is that, you know, yeah, I'm comfortable trading 10 lots. I'm comfortable trading one lot, you know. But the thing is, you have to know, you have to have some amount of luck. I mean, I just got unlucky. It's just like, that's why sometimes I refer to myself as Mr. Inflection Point, because I'll, you know, they'll put me in a trade, like, and for some strange reason, they'll put me right where the market turns, and I never get a chance to exit that particular trade with a profit. So I wind up either averaging in or stopping out. So, you know, we're looking at the pound right now. It's just crisscrossing that 50 line. I mean, if you had taken that short, you could have made 2, maybe 3 pips. Boom. And it's like, no, I don't poo-poo if it was 20 cents. I said that it's only 20 cents because that's the way a lot of traders talk. If it's on a $100 account, like you said, if you do that 5 times a week and you just made 1% in a week, if you do it 5 times a day, you just made 1% in a day. And, that's 250% in a year. So, you know, you'll be one of the best money managers on the world if you can do that.
You're absolutely right. You know, and we have to go and just, but the thing is, I think what we need to do is we need to go and set, you know, realistic expectations. And by setting realistic expectations, we can go and, you know, get what we need to get and be good and happy with it. You know, and that's the important part. We have to be good and happy with what, you know, we can get, you know. And, you know, it's sort of like, you know, I called it chunting. I think you called getting the lion's share. And I think I used the story with you. You know, getting the lion's share doesn't mean that you get the entire, if you get a trend, let's say that trend was for 30 or 40 pips, getting the lion's share doesn't necessarily mean that you get, you know, 80% of that big run. No, getting the lion's share is getting what you need, you know, and that's what's important, because here's, you know.
Well, one thing, you know what? The fastest 15 minutes in trading is up, Walmart. We'll have to continue tomorrow. So, fellow traders, don't be greedy, you know, and don't discount small wins, because it's not what you trade, it's how you trade it. So go out there and drain the banks. This is the Rumpled One, over and out.